Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. Artcast number 66, I think. How's everybody doing? Sorry, I didn't get yesterday's Artcast up till late. But when I did that big old video, I think it ended up coming out at like an hour and like 18 minutes or 20 minutes or something. It took like, sorry I'm breathing hard, I kind of run out to the front door real quick right as I started this video, but it took like, god, it took, I think, well, I think it took more like about 5 or 6 hours to render. It didn't finally get done rendering. I think I started at like, well, I don't know. I should have put it in the editing program like that night that I shot it and rendered it then, like overnight, and then I might have still got it up the next day. But what I did, I just filmed it. It was so late. I went in bed and I just thought, well, I'll stick it in Sony Vegas like first thing in the morning and render it. And I did that, and then it just rendered like forever. Until I had to, well, until after dinner. And then, I went to upload it, and I don't know, I went to bed about 1 or so, and still wasn't completely uploaded. It was just a huge video. I don't know why I made one quite so long, but I thought I was actually kind of joking around about making, like, my longest video in there. I tell you, it's like, I don't know. But it kind of sucks, because I, you know, I did all the work to get the thing up and everything, and then I didn't make it, so. Anyway, maybe I'll do a Saturday video or something, but to make up for it, but I don't know. Now that I do the Artcast with, or the Artcasters chat with Peter Palmiotti on Sundays, the chat show, you know, I always feel like I really don't get a day off without a video. So if I do one Saturday, then I totally don't. And I've kind of been working a little bit on thinking, well, I don't know if I've been working. That might be jumping the gun. I've been thinking about trying to do like a tutorial video or something, like on the side. There's something I could maybe put on Gumroad, and I don't know, possibly just, I don't know if it'll be free or just, you know, the way Gumroad works where you can give a little if you want to kind of thing. I'm not sure. But I kind of want to do one because I get people asking me to do speed paints on here, and they got a lot of technique questions. And I don't know. I've kind of chose this kind of format because I like it. I like listening to the videos like mine, like I've talked about in the past, and I kind of like just sticking with it. I don't really feel like making like speed paint videos and stuff like that. The thing I don't like much about speed paints is that the camera is in the way for the whole picture, you know, beginning to end. Whereas, like, you know, the way I do it now, it's kind of, it's only in the way for a while. Eventually I can kind of get it, put it aside and get to work. So yeah, I don't know. I did, went ahead and just started this one because I was waiting for a couple approvals on some commissions, and I kind of got caught with like no photo reference or any kind of work to do for a day. So I don't know, I had the photo reference for this printed out. I just thought, well, I'll just go for it. I haven't done a nude for a while. I wanted to do a few more for like the guys that like that stuff. Put it up on eBay, so. And I wanted to thank everybody that passed around my Indiana Jones painting that I did. Sold pretty well on eBay. I was real happy. So definitely want to do a few more. I want to explore a lot of things now, you know. And I'm sure you guys will see as time goes on. I got a few commissions to do this week, which is nice. Kind of almost reminds me of a week like when I used to do sketch cards a little more, because I did get a couple commissions. I just got another one yesterday that's going to be real fun, and it's kind of like I'm almost kind of struggling to get something back up on eBay for sale, you know, and I like that. I actually do have one more I owe somebody, a drawing, and I got to get to that one. I cleaned up a couple of the other ones I owed people earlier this week, like that X-Files one. He hadn't been waiting too long, but there's another one. Can't remember what it was that I did, you know, because I don't like to owe people. I really hate it when somebody... I mean, sometimes I don't hate it, because it's like sometimes I just need it, but like when somebody pays me early and then I have to do their piece later on, it's like, oh no, you know. So I really try to like do my commissions as soon as I get them anymore, but I was just going to throw the highlights in her hair, but I think it kind of looks a little better if I draw it out a little more, just from what I can see so far, so I'm going to do that. Yeah, that video yesterday, whoa, man, that took forever. I guess it's been a while since I did like a really long one. I think they've been kind of hitting around 30 minutes lately. And, yeah, when I was like, put it in there to render, I was just like, oh, yeah, this will be no problem. 3 o'clock, I'll have this thing up. And no way, I think it was like, you know, 40-something percent or something. I was like, oh, no. But it's been a lot easier, I've noticed, to like just do videos. I'm getting more into like a habit of like, yeah, it's just time to do the video, and you know, and even like trying to get one early on Mondays, and it's nice. I really wondered, I think, what was going to happen, you know, because I'm known to like kind of get going all gung ho on a project and then drop off at some point because I'm bored or something, and I was really hoping that wouldn't happen here with this, but I don't know. I don't know. Sometimes I don't stop myself from doing that just because it's like, if it's boring, I just, you know, to me, like if I'm bored, everybody else is going to be bored with the work I'm producing. So I kind of let that, you know, I just let it happen sometimes if it's going to happen because I think it's better. It kind of takes me in a better direction, I guess, because like what'll come out of that is something more interesting. But you know what kind of sucks is when people get into the work you're doing, like sometimes with the web comics I did and stuff, people immediately get into that and then you're like, well, I don't know if I want to do that anymore, that's not good. So but yeah, with the video thing, it's like, it hasn't, I'm definitely not bored doing it, and I really was wondering if I would be. People kind of have even, I don't know, they just, you know, they give me ideas for shows and stuff and say like that exact thing. It's like, I know it's probably hard to think of like what to do a show about, but it's funny, I don't really even do the topic thing because I like actually when I just don't have a topic and I just start talking. Because a lot of times then I get on to like what I'm actually thinking about. And I find those are the best shows for some reason. Because it's like I'm almost just like having a conversation with you guys. But it feels more like I'm just having a conversation at lunch with one of my friends or something. Except for nobody's talking back, I guess. Not getting any arguments. No, I'm kidding, but yeah, it's weird. I've noticed it. You know, I think that it's like, I mean, another example is I take a walk most, I used to be taking them in the evenings, I still do that, but I've been taking, getting up and going for one in the morning, because, you know, I've realized that, like, I'm sitting around, like, all day now drawing, and I've never really had a job that's just so, like, passive like that, you know. I've always had pretty active jobs, and it's just weird, you know, in a way, and I can almost feel my body kind of having troubles with it a little bit, you know. Like, the first week I was sitting at home drawing all day, I noticed, like, my hand got kind of sore, and my fingers and stuff, but I think that all that just sort of sorted itself out, and now I'm kind of getting used to it. But I don't know, just sitting here, not, you know, I don't know, I don't want my body to just completely fall apart. So I've been kind of like pushing it, like, you know, going for longer walks in the morning and stuff. And plus, Cinder needs a good walk anyway, you know. That's her fun time. Yeah, I can hear her out there making noise. I should open the door, let her in. Hang on. So I'm back. Now Cinder's in here staring at me. You can go outside if you want. I opened the front door so she could go outside if she wants, but then she just comes back here and looks at me. Breathes hard. If you can hear her breathing, I don't know. There she goes. So what was I talking about? I don't remember now. Oh, you know what? About going for walks, actually. And I notice, like, when I go for a walk, I really like it, because I notice, like, I get a lot of ideas. And, I used to be, like, I used to actually have a job being a delivery driver a long time ago. And I had that job for, like, quite a few years. And I noticed I'd always get, like, all these great ideas when I would drive around. And I noticed I have that same kind of thing when I go for walks. And, but I have a harder time. I notice, like, when I go for a walk in the evening, I usually, me and Tristan go. And the dog, of course. And I have a harder time coming up with ideas, because it's like me and Tristan are, like, talking and stuff, you know. But yeah, like, the morning walk, I like it. And I can see, like, I've listened to some podcasts where guys do that as their podcast, basically, where they just go for a walk and they just talk. And that I could see how that would work, because I just kind of notice, like, as I'm walking around talking in my own head, it's like, it's kind of like the the show in a way, because I'm, like, sitting there, like, talking to myself and planning out my day and what I'm going to do, and just it's been helpful. It really has been helpful, I noticed, to kind of do that in the morning. It's like when I come in to my studio later, then I come home, have breakfast, and it's like when I hit my studio, man, I'm, like, ready to go. You know, I don't waste a bunch of time thinking, you know, what am I going to do and all that kind of stuff. Which, that's like this, the kiss of death, I think. I remember I used to, when I painted, I painted a house, or I painted quite a few things for this guy, but he owned an auto body shop in Boulder here. I won't say which one. But did a bunch of painting for the guy, or not an auto body shop, but it was just a auto repair place, and the guy was really successful, made a ton of money, and he was kind of like one of these old immigrant type guys who was just as cheap as you could get, and I think he probably had most of the money he made he probably still had. But it was, I used to hate working for him, because it was like he'd always want something extra, so he'd always get you on whatever job you got going, and then he'd want some extra thing, and then it was like you always had to, I felt like I had to go beg for the money every time, you know. It was like he could never just leave me a check like everybody else does, or just give it to me when I asked for it. He was like, there'd always be some, you know, like, come by the shop, I'll pay you there, and, you know, things like that. And then I'd go there and I'd have to, like, hang around and listen to all his troubles, you know. It just seemed like it was like all these hoops to just jump through just to get the damn check, you know. But he was a pretty good client. He always had a lot of work for me. And, but he also was, like, cheap as hell. He, you know, that was the other thing. He's always trying to talk you down. And then he would, and you, you know, and I noticed, like, there's very few people that'll do this. But sometimes, and I notice a lot of times it is kind of, which I don't want to sound racist or anything, but immigrant type people, maybe, I don't know, what am I saying? That's not right. But just, I don't know. The two people I came across was this guy and then this other lady who was from China that owned a restaurant that would do this to me. But they would like try to talk you down after the fact. So they talk you down in the beginning. And then when they're giving you their check, they're still trying to talk you down. And that to me is like, you know, it's one thing to try to talk you down beforehand, but I always felt like that's just not right afterwards, you know. And I would always come down a little on the price in the beginning, but I never would drop anything at the end, you know. I'd always be like, no, that's what we agreed on, you know. But anyway, back to the point of all this stuff was... The guy, he told me, he would talk to me all the time because he really liked the idea of like being in business, and he loved to talk business basically. And he started his own business and had worked for somebody before that. Worked for some automotive place, but he wasn't like a mechanic or anything. He was, I think he just worked at like almost like a dealership, you know. This was like years ago though, and he talked about how he couldn't pay his bills, you know what I mean. He was like had to borrow money from his mom, he would say, you know, to pay my freaking rent, you know. And he had like three kids or something and a wife, and I'm sure it was tough. And he would just, you know, just be like, that's just ridiculous that you're working for somebody who can't pay your bills, you know. And honestly, I tell you, I understand it. Even, you know, like, I did have my own painting company for quite a while, and then when I went back to work this last time, I went back to a guy that I had worked for, like, years before, because I thought, well, that's just the easiest thing to do right now. Then I got a check, you know. And it was like I kind of forgot how damn hard it is to make money working for somebody. Hang on, I'm kind of getting off camera there. It was tough. It was super tough. And sometimes, like, I wouldn't, you know, oftentimes I wouldn't be able to make my money for what we needed, you know. But I was the only person working most of the time, but... Still, it's like, you know, if you got a job, you should be able to pay your bills, in my opinion. But, I mean, the point of this whole thing was the guy gave me actually some great advice one time, and he was talking about how he starts his day, and he'd make a list while he eats his breakfast of what he needs to do. And he showed me he had this little tiny notebook he carried around everywhere, and it was just a list of the stuff he did. And he, you know, even though he ran like a, you know, an automotive shop where they fixed cars, he didn't do any of that kind of work, you know. He just managed the place basically. He had mechanics and his kid worked there, and you know, he just did the office stuff or whatever, didn't do any of the actual work. That sender making noise in here now. I might have to boot her out. She's just kind of okay. Now she got quiet as soon as I said that. She probably heard me. But he used to carry around this little notebook, and he'd tell me that. He'd be like, you know, it's a good way of keeping track of, you know, making sure you get done what you need to get done every day. And he basically would say he'd write everything down they needed to do, and then the stuff he didn't get done, in the morning he'd take it off the page from before and he'd write it onto the new page. So like every day he would basically kind of just sit there and eat his breakfast and think about what he had to do and make a list of like, oh, I don't want to forget that, I need to do this, I need to do that. And then, you know, like, I mean, I really find it now. And I actually used to do that when I painted, too. I kind of adopted that. But lately, I've really found that it's been helping me. I think I kind of got out of the habit when I was working for that other guy painting houses. But, now I've been doing it a lot, just making that list, and I've also been kind of just making a daily list of like what I'm making if I sell a print or all that kind of stuff, and planning out like what I gotta do to make enough money each week. And it's like most of the time it doesn't work out the way it's supposed to, but it's really helping, you know. Because art is like, you know, you can't just say, oh, I'm going to do this in this amount of time and it's going to be what it is. I think it's even tougher when you're selling stuff every day, because you got to make every piece, you know, awesome. You can't just make something like half-assed and expect anybody to give a shit about it and buy it. You know, every piece has got to sell itself some way. So, anyway, for all the hassle to get my money out of that guy, he definitely gave me a good tip right there. And I'd say the other tip is to not work for anybody. My dad was talking about my nephew, who's a diesel mechanic, and pretty young. And he's trying to kind of like open his own shop, basically. Making these kind of souped up trucks. And doing that for people. Which it's like, I don't know if there's a business there or not. But he kind of was, which gets me too, is like my dad of all people was saying this. Because he's like completely usually on my side about this. But he was like, well, you know, what's the point? He's got a good job. He makes a good check. Why do that? You know what I mean? But it's like, I mean, I think that it's like if you can work for yourself, you're so much going to be so much better off, because, you know, I mean, I've definitely worked for a ton of people in my life, and inevitably, you know, I've noticed, and maybe other people can manage it, but what I've noticed is like that stuff runs out. And then, you know, if you don't have a backup plan, you're like scrambling. And who the hell's got a backup plan to their main source of income, you know? Most people don't. And it just happened over and over in my life, you know? Because things change, you know? And, like the first big company that kind of took me on a roller coaster ride was the newspaper business. And, you know, that just happened because the internet and the world changed, you know, nobody could see that coming. But I think this one's coming out pretty good. I'm actually going to cut this video kind of short, because I don't want to get into another big old hassle with getting it rendered and stuff. So this one will be up on eBay too. And like I said, I got a couple commissions. You guys come back and watch me draw some of those. I got some questions too. If anybody's got questions, go ahead and, you know, feel free to stick them in the comments on YouTube or my site or whatever. And I'm more than happy to answer them. Because, yeah, not many people have been asking lately, but sometimes I get questions, though, like this guy, Deanne on DeviantArt, asked me about, like, the photo reference and, like, how do I pick pictures and stuff like that. And I don't know. I just don't really have much of an answer for that. I hate to say it, but it's kind of true. So I think this is turning out kind of cool. I thought it'd be a good piece. I don't know. I want to mix it up. I want to spread my base out. You know what I mean? And do more stuff that's all over the place. So that I don't get bored. I don't get maybe pigeonholed as much. Because I'm sick of that shit. I'm just, like, sick of people, like, acting like all I can do is just, you know, copy movie art or something like that. That shit's going away. Because that's just a bunch of BS. But, you know, that's a lot of, like, the jealous, you know, artist bullshit that happens on the net. And, yeah, I don't know. I just want to do a bunch of stuff, though. And not just for that reason. I'm not just doing it as a reactionary thing, but just because I want to, because I have all these ideas. I'm getting all these ideas when I walk around, so I want to do some of them. Anyway, take care, guys, and I'll see you next time.